Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Lieutenant Governor Casey Cagle. He says he's got about 20 seconds for you. Thank you.
Oh, well, thank you, John. Wow, what a, you know, that was a wonderful, wonderful speech. John and I was talking behind the stage there, and we actually said, he said he would yield me 30 seconds, and I said, well, I'm going to go a little more than 30 seconds, but that would be good. It is great to be with all of you today, and I was enjoyed being with many of you through the breakfast this morning, along with the dinner last night, and many of you heard me say this morning that Nydia and I have had many, many special things that have occurred in our lives. But one of those real special things is my oldest son and our daughter-in-law gave us our first grandchild, a little girl by the name of Everett Grace. And Nydia and I are thrilled to death. Everybody tells me that, you know, you love your kids, but you fall in love with your grandkids. And there could not be a truer statement than that. I will say, though, I do have to enter her into beauty contests on a pretty regular basis. And I told my son and daughter-in-law this, and they says, what in the world are you talking about? I says, well, you know, in the worlds that I live in, there are other men that come up and they talk about their granddaughter and how beautiful they are. And so I have to pull out a picture of Everett Grace and show them how pretty she is every single time, and she wins hands down. And it's a great, great joy and a great time of our life. But I want to mostly say thank you. Thank you to each and every person that is representative here today. You're the individuals that have allowed Georgia to be in the place that it is. And you've allowed me to be the Lieutenant Governor and the first Republican Lieutenant Governor in the history of Georgia. And I will forever be indebted and grateful for your steadfast commitment to the conservative principles that each of us adhere to on a daily basis. I do want to pivot for a moment and just say that I do believe that this presidential election is one of the most important elections that we will face. We have sat by and watched really the Obama administration, which quite candidly a Clinton administration is going to be no different, to where executive orders are going to be the way in which they bypass the process. I can tell you firsthand, I have witnessed the federal government trying to tell the state, violating states' rights time and time again, and that is fundamentally wrong. Ladies and gentlemen, we do not need the federal government running our educational system right here in Georgia. And we've got to stand up every single time and fight back, and we will do it. And I will tell you, when I look at issues like the federal debt, over $19 trillion, and I look in this audience and I look at each one of you and me, and we recognize that it's going to cost us $160,000 to pay that debt individually. And sadly enough, it's my little granddaughter, your children, and your grandchildren that are going to bear that burden. What we need to do as states, and particularly as Georgia, is be a leader. Show Washington and show the country what it's like to balance a budget, what it's like to keep taxes low, what it's about to make sure that jobs are growing and that we are a strong environment to be the number one place to do business in the country, and correcting and making education the very best that it can be. That's what can happen. And when it comes to our next president, I want to say a quick little story. Some years back, I had the great privilege of going to Normandy. And I want you to listen to me because this is an important point and certainly one by which touched my life. As I walked onto that island and I looked at not only all of the white crosses that were before me, but I looked over to my right and I saw the cliff that fell off into the ocean. And I looked there and thought of all the individuals that gave their life. It was pretty amazing and pretty surreal. But as I walked over to that cliff and I looked down and I saw how large of a cliff it was, I visualized the men and the women, the individuals that were coming onto, swimming into the shore and climbing up on that cliff, even though bombs were coming down on top of them. What bravery, what courage, what loyalty, and what sense of calling and duty they exemplified. And as we laid a wreath there, the emotion that filled my heart is one that I will never forget. Ladies and gentlemen, that freedom, this flag that we look at behind me today, is worth the fight. And ladies and gentlemen, I want you to know that whether we like this president, whether we had a different choice, it doesn't matter. Because there are some things that are greater than our own personal feelings. And when it comes to the next Supreme Court justices, that's not going to be a one-year issue, a two-year issue. It's going to be decades that are going to, we are going to have to live with the choices. So it is going to be up to us to carry that badge of courage, to carry the badge of a conservative principles, to make sure that we have a president of the United States that will uphold the freedoms and the liberties that we stand in the trenches and fight for each and every day. And I believe we have that man. And now is the time to unite together to make sure we do all that we can to preserve this great country. May God bless you, and may God bless America.